Welcome back to Let's Play The Outer Worlds, Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We are now playing the new patch. 1.1.1, or 1.1.137 or something like that. It's just a few minor things. I think subtitles got bigger, or the option to have them bigger. I'm not completely sure, because I don't know if this was here before. I think it was? I'm not even sure. But I have it unchecked. I never found the text to be small. I mean, maybe if you're playing on a, TV screen, you're playing console, yeah. And there's something related to the PS4, I don't even know. And another place that had a crash, place you haven't been yet, so mostly does not pertain to us. But we have to go to the Groundbreaker for a few different things. The main quest here, we have to access a data cartridge for a terminal in the Groundbreaker security office. I'm looking at the empty man. Oh, I'm looking at this. Okay, so that's for Max, and then the main quest also leads us there. Speak to Phyllis on the Groundbreaker. She'll sell us a nav key to Stellar Bay on Monarch. And then this is, yeah, acquire the science weapon on Groundbreaker. And then the only thing not is the, I'm not completely sure what this is, the acid steeper, which we can have apparently a robot or auto mechanical, I guess, as a companion, but we need to pick up a part from Roseway, and I don't know what or where is Roseway. So, 3 out of 4 things lead to the Groundbreaker, so we're going to the Groundbreaker. And we think we used this to get there. This is exciting. Well, there's the Groundbreaker. Let's take a look at everything here. So we are here, Terra 2. AG-332. An idyllic terrestrial planet. Halcyon's wealthiest elite live in its capital city, Byzantium, while the colony's laborers live in corporate-owned townships along the frontier. So you can travel to planets, asteroids, and labs. This is Phineas' lab, an abandoned and asteroid facility located in the rings of Terra 2, repurposed into the experimental laboratory living quarters and hideout of Phineas Vernon Wells. That'd be exciting to visit that. Groundbreaker, independent orbital station in the remains of Halcyon's first colony ship, captained by Jean-Li Tennyson and run by descendants of the original crew. These are other places we can go, apparently. Typhon. Can't go. Well, so I guess we can go to these. We can go to Monarch if you want to, but we need a key. We can go to Scylla? Scylla? I think it's Scylla. There's something called the Scylla. I think it was in a, correct me if I'm wrong, but I was watching someone's playthrough, because I can't play scary games. And I'm going off on a tangent here, but I, Call of Cthulhu, the newer game, had a ship called the Scylla, and the characters pronounced it in-game, and they said Scylla, and I think it's named after some historical or mythological figure from long ago, either one. So, Scylla. What is this, anyway? One of the largest asteroids orbiting Halcyon, the largest in a grouping of rocks known as the Charybdis Cluster. Hephaestus Mining once claimed the asteroid, but its prospecting site was abandoned decades ago. Tartarus is locked off. We can see a lock there, specifically. AG-434. AG. What is AG? So we got AG numbers. Tartarus, named after its hellish atmosphere. Tartarus is where the board maintains the maximum security penal complex known as the Labyrinth. Ooh, that's interesting. So, and then we got Eridanos. AG-211. Halcyon's second Jovian gas giant. Its atmosphere is rich with hydrogen, helium, and various noble gases. Distillation plants in the atmosphere harvest these gases for energy. Monarch, AG-111A. One of Olympus's many satellites, what should have been Halcyon's second habitable world has long since been abandoned by the board due to monstrous, ravenous creatures. Oh my. Olympus, AG-111. The largest of Halcyon's two Jovian gas giants, perpetual storms rack the planet's atmosphere, rendering it inhabitable. Is that the same thing? Perpetual storms? Oh, no. Well, no idea what this is. And Typhon, AG-642, an uninhabitable icy planetoid at the edge of the Halcyon system. Typhon has nothing to offer the Halcyon colony. Hephaestus. The closest planet to the sun, the Hephaestus Mining Company was first to establish outposts here, and as such, it has claimed the planet for itself. How greedy of them. Alright, so let's go to the Groundbreaker. Groundbreaker docking bays. Okay. That reminds me of Mass Effect 3, with the traveling around the solar system and being chased by little reapers. So that's pretty interesting. It seems like a cross between basically Mass Effect and Fallout. Welcome to the system map. Here you can see all the planets in the system, as well as some special points of interest that you may have discovered. Isn't that what we already looked at? We've already figured that out. You can fly your ship to any location you have unlocked, though some landing bays require special codes and keys before they allow you to land there. Moving between planets is considered extremely dangerous, and all employees are encouraged to remain home or at work.
The Groundbreaker.
So wait, should we test this out? Is this a stupid thing to do? Because I want it. Well, that was a stupid thing to do. Is this? I just want to see what happens. Warning, dangerous, Cascadia landing pad. Just want to see what happens, guys. Yeah, it's not controlled, it's just
message
automatic.
From Dr. Wells. He'd like to congratulate you on finding a route to Monarch.
Put him on screen.
Cascadia is utterly seething with dangerous, highly aggressive creatures, more than capable of tearing you limb from limb. You'd have to be a lunatic to land in Cascadia, and I'm reasonably certain I tested your brain for incipient signs of insanity. Trust me, talk to Gladys Kulkelly.
I'm gonna fight my way over land to Stellar Bay. No, like, this is a mistake. Ada, get me out of here.
Yes, Captain. Initiating travel sequence to the Groundbreaker.
Wait, I didn't say go there specifically.
Destination reached. The Groundbreaker.
I know this is crazy. I just want to see how they stop me from landing. I'm very curious. The other places we can't even select.
Destination reached. Scylla.
Scylla? So it's not Scylla.
Welcome back, Captain. How can I be of assistance?
I'd like to continue our conversation from before.
Forgive me, Captain. I would rather not discuss Alex Hawthorne today. I am feeling discombobulated. Was there another topic on your mind?
She wants to change the subject. I'm not going to push it. But we don't need to discuss Alex directly. But I was wondering how he improved your design.
Captain Hawthorne attached 98.4% of the ship's processes to my computer, thereby giving me near total control.
Is that a good thing?
I have been programmed to deftly calculate navigation vectors through asteroid fields while also operating our ship's toasters.
Toasters.
Alex also taught me the concept of a personality. He was quite delighted when I crafted one in order to better engage with him. It was basic in the beginning.
Hmm. Where did you come from originally?
The information in my memory banks says I am an autonomous digital astrogator created by, redacted, on the date of, redacted,
oh God,
for the express purpose of, redacted. I have not yet decided if I should attempt to uncover the missing information regarding my birth. I asked once. Alex did not build me, and would not say who did.
Hmm.
How can I be of assistance?
Mm-hmm. Now, I'm just very curious, guys. I know I'm not going where I'm supposed to, but... This is my party. Although it's the lot. Okay. They said the place is abandoned.
Got a sec?
Oh. Oh well. Wait. Let me just hold on.
Hey, Captain. I heard that Groundbreaker's got a real good engineer. A lady named Junlei Tennyson.
What about her?
I was thinking that maybe I ought to meet her. If you got time to swing us by, I mean. I don't got much experience fixing actual spaceships. I bet you a can of Borst and Beans she could teach me all manner of stuff.
Makes sense to me. Next time we dock at the Groundbreaker, I'll try to remember.
Thanks, Captain. I'll be sure to make it worth your time. Did you want to talk about anything else before we moved on?
No, we'll talk later.
I find myself marveling at the complex simplicity of the Fibonacci spiral. Something vexing you, Captain?
No.
This is real space, isn't it? Empty and silent. Never thought I'd see the like. I'd look up at night, but...
Can't walk 5 meters without stubbing your toe on a loose rock here.
Yeah, we're not supposed to be here yet. I figured we couldn't really... I figured we'd be stopped by somebody and it would be like an interesting conversation. They have these things here, too? What the hell's going on? What are you two doing? Can you even jump down there? Yes.
Get cover, Captain!
No!
Yes, I hear a sprat. So we can go down this way. Yeah, we're not supposed to be here yet. Okay. I don't want to get in deep to this. I just was curious. Just a quick look. We'll go the Monarch now, like we're supposed to. Sorry to have frustrated anybody. Just an explorer by heart. Not only do I like to explore, but I like to explore what a game will and won't let you do. Groundbreaker ho, docking bays. Whatever's on Scylla is probably too hard for us.
Destination reached. The Groundbreaker.
Hard to handle.
Welcome back, Captain. How can I be of assistance?
I don't know.
I'll be here.
Alright, so we're going to the Groundbreaker. Yeah. Continue. Groundbreaker. I wonder if we're getting any trouble here, or it's just going to be talking to some people.
Yeah, huh?
So, I did save the game after having a conversation with her, so it did...
I find myself marveling at the...
transpire.
Something vexing you, Captain?
Just checking your ship's manifest. Standard procedure. Welcome to Groundbreaker, by the by.
Oh, don't mind the heat.
Thank you.
Got a few days before it reaches critical. I'm sure Miss Chief Tennyson will get it sorted before then.
Thank you, by the by. Take a quick look over here. Because there's stuff. You know if there's stuff. Auto mag pistol. Figure it's far enough away from everybody. What's an auto mag pistol? If you want some serious pyre power but aren't ready to step up to a heavy weapon, then the TNL Automag line is for you. Alright, so that's how to get back to my ship. I suppose there's nothing of interest on this pad. We can fall down there and die. I've seen something like that happen already.
Smells like grease and unwashed bodies. Just as I remembered.
Smell the unwashed bodies from here?
That's not the point. This halfwit just knocked out one of my workers.
Yeah, with a tossball stick, I heard you the first time.
More dead?
There weren't any witnesses.
Felix?
No witnesses. He's not even denying it.
Jackass had it coming.
Shut it, Felix. You're not making this any better.
You get cute with me again, you little back-bay brat, I will toss you out an airlock.
This is the Groundbreaker, not Byzantium. You ain't the law here. I am. Now move along.
Get him.
I don't have time for this.
Hello, Felix?
Going for a stroll around the docking base?
I noticed you were in the middle of an argument earlier, like about a second earlier.
Sure was. Got a knack for upsetting the board and the Mardets all at once. Between you and me, I was hoping they'd come to fisticuffs.
The Mardets. I thought her name was Mardet. That guard threatened to toss you out in the airlock.
Yeah, yeah. He's like the rest of those bored jackasses. All bluster, no grit. All you gotta do is square your shoulders and stand up to him. Bored ain't accustomed to disobedience.
Why would I say be saying slow down? Well, what exactly did you do?
Guy never liked me. Always trying to get a rise out of me. But I keep my chin up, right? Be the bigger man, I tell myself. He's a spacer's chosen man, though. So when the Chosen beat my Rangers the other night, my foreman comes swaggering up with his head full of boasting.
Wait. So we've got Spacer's Choice, and then some kind of group within Spacer's Choice called the Spacer's Chosen. That's different. So you defend the honor of your team.
Exactly. I was only doing what any self-respecting Rangers fan would have done. Look, this was a long time coming. Guy thinks he can push me around because he's some sky-high foreman, and I'm just a back-bay's dock worker. Well, former dock worker. Guess I just tendered my resignation.
Huh. Got any plans?
Enjoy my freedom. Scrounge together enough bits for a zero-G. Other than that, can't say as I do. Hey, not for nothing, but I saw you wander out of that ship over there by the dock. Wouldn't happen to be yours, would it?
That's me, Captain of the Unreliable.
Captain of the Unreliable. You're like something out of a serial drama.
Oh yeah?
Hey, I don't want to talk your ears off, guessing you got places to be. I appreciate your time.
Never caught your name. I'm Alicia Clark.
Felix Millstone. Pleased to make your acquaintance.
Future companion. If he is, guys, or if he isn't, don't tell me. See you around, Felix.
See you around, boss.
He's already calling me boss. Mardette. You are a Mardette, not the Mardette.
Just arrived. Head over to customs. Wheeler needs to process you.
This one might see me. Steve Dorr?
Gonna head to Veer's for whiskey and darts. Maybe not in that order.
Well, you're wearing goggles. I thought it was some kind of face paint.
Yeah, I've done work for Sublight. Need to pay the bill somehow.
Mechanicals all over, but they still got us sweating to move boxes.
I'm not familiar with these titles, Steve Dorr and Mardette. I keep thinking they're people's names. Hi.
Do you mind? I'm trying to file a report.
Oh. And no, it required so much concentration.
Hey.
Hey. You're not bad looking for a Mardette. I want this stuff. Can you go away or something? Was she literally following me around? Where'd the Mardette go? Not here? Energy cells. Hi. Oh, wait, what's that on top? Stogie Slims? Pack of Stogie Slims, nicotine high, range weapon spread. -50%. Slam a Slim, now available in regular, super, menthol, and blue cheese. It's not even spell like the French spell it. B-L-E-U cheese.
Mechanicals all over, but they still got us weapons and boxes.
I've actually already talked to that person. Alright. Yeah, I'm not going in there with this guy standing right there. See if there's anything down here. Stairs. What is it called? Gigantor? Gigantor energy drink. I got a Mardet ID cartridge. For use with the holographic shroud, you'll now be automatically disguised when entering the associated restricted area. I love it. Sweet.
What do you think you're doing?
Oh. Did he say you take the shroud or just open that thing? Persuade 25. I was just leaving.
Oh, I guess, never mind then.
Oh, he was behind me. Alright. Gonna have to be careful around here.
You learn to keep your eyes to yourself in my job. Nobody wants you looking close at their cargo.
Like what I'm doing?
If it wasn't for us, this whole damn station would shut down.
I wanna learn what a stevedore is.
We move cargo 16 hours a day, and half of us still can't afford a bed.
That's horrible. So there's more this way. Just in case I got stuck. Well, I don't know if I can jump over this. No, alright. I was gonna see if I could walk around there, hop this fence, and then see what might be over there, but we can't even hop this fence, so.
It's always fucking freezing in the bays.
Careful where you smoke. Crew bills us for air filtration.
I don't smoke, don't worry about that. Help the chairman and Minister Clark defeat our foes. Borstwurst. We've seen some of these posters. Wanted, Phineas Wells. Sedition, forgery, conspiracy. Conspiracy to commit conspiracy. Unlicensed medical practice and destruction of board property.
I wonder what that fella did to get the board so riled at him.
Probably displayed any kind of actual personality and free thinking for himself. McCred. Captain Gunnar McCred. For several counts of public intoxication, destruction of groundbreaker property, unpaid docking fees, and resisting arrest, contact Commandant Sanita if you have any information concerning McCred's whereabouts. Failure to report a tip may result in imprisonment and a fine. Proof of kill required to collect reward. Another finger?
Cargo 16 hours a day, and half of us still can't afford a bed.
It's always fucking freezing in the bays.
Oh, stuck on something. Or someone. Any machine.
Inspection, right this way.
Wheeler's over here? I'll be right there, Wheeler. Board approved.
Not crew, you're little people.
I'm little people? I'm one of the little people. Restricted access. Oh. I'm probably fine going in there with it. How many? Well, I have 30 magpicks? That's pretty sweet. I am exploring. I'll register soon enough. Was it empty bottles? That looks like you can climb that for and find something interesting. Or not really. Unless I'm supposed to jump to there. I don't know if I can make that jump. I did. I made that jump. No one's over here, apparently. Oh, I thought you were someone spotting me for a second. No mag fix required. These are takes, anyway, not steals. 50 bits, nice. A bracelet. This is a simple metal bracelet. This bracelet would make the perfect accessory for a night in the town, or just dinner at the local establishment. The original owner probably spent a few bits to buy it. Nine more bits here. So just a little hidden area? And then we could be back there. I'll keep that in mind. Let me go register. Oh, can I even get back up? Oh wait, yeah. Ow. I'll be alright. I'll be alright. One way or the other. It's sealed. So that's behind him. Hi.
Identification, please.